In this illustration, we'll study about the displacement of a mercury column. Here we are given that a column of mercury 10 cm long is contained in the middle of a narrow horizontal 1 meter long tube, which is closed at both ends. And both halves of the tube contain air at a pressure of 76 cm of mercury. It is asking by what distance will the column of mercury be displaced if the tube is held vertically. Now, in the solution here, first we can draw the picture. If we consider this is the tube, which is 1 meter long and the middle 10 cm contain mercury. So, if this 10 cm on both the side, it is 45 cm and 45 cm length of air column on the two sides of this mercury pellet. And on both the sides, the pressure is given to us as P, and the value of P in initial state, we can write initially when tube is horizontal, pressure of air is given as 76 cm of mercury. And here the volume of air is given to us as 45 cm of tube. Now, when the tube is tilted in a vertical manner like this, then obviously due to weight, mercury column will displace slightly in downward direction. So it is displaced down by x, its length is still 10 cm, but if it is displaced by x, the upper length will be 45 plus x, and the lower part will be having a length 45 minus x cm. Now, if it is made vertically, you can see the pressure of the upper part is P1, the pressure in the lower part will be P plus 10 cm of mercury, because this 10 cm is the mercury column. Now, in this situation here, we can write, finally, when tube is made vertical, in this situation, we can write P1 for the upper part, we can take up it as P1, and the volume here is 45 plus x must be equals to initial PV. Here we can write as temperature is constant, then by gas law, we can write P1 V1 as P2 V2. So this is the relation which we are getting. Say this is equation 1, and second equation for the lower part, we can write P1 plus 10 multiplied by 45 minus x is equals to same PV. Now, from these two equations, here if we equate the two terms on the left hand side, we can see it is 45 P1 plus x P1 is equals to this is 45 P1 plus 450 minus x P1 minus 10x. Here 45 P1 gets cancelled out. On simplifying, the value of P1 we are getting is 450 minus 10x divided by 2x. Or it is 225 minus 5x by x. So, as we have got the value of P1 in terms of the displacement of this mercury column, we can use it in equation 1. So, from equation 1, we can write the value of P1 here is 225 minus 5x by x multiplied by 45 plus x is equals to PV. The values we are already having, 76 multiplied by 45. Here all values I am taking in centimeter of mercury and centimeter of tube. So on the two sides of equality, the equation will remain homogeneous. Now if we further cross multiply it and simplify, this 76 multiplied by 45 becomes 3420. We can also cross multiply, this is x. is when this left hand side we multiply, I'm writing the left hand side on the other side. This 10125 minus 225x plus 225x minus 5x square. So this 225x also gets cancelled out. On simplifying, there's a quadratic equation which is x square plus 684x minus 2025 is equals to 0. Now you can directly simplify this quadratic equation and get the roots of x. I'm directly writing the result here. You can discard the negative root of x, which is the displacement of Mercury column, as it cannot displace upward, it will only displace in downward direction. The value of x will be getting here will be 2.95 cm. That will be the result of this problem. Here I've left this solution as an exercise for you to evaluate this quadratic equation roots and verify the result.